Hi, in this video I will show you how to make a cheap air humidifier, aromatizer or mist maker. I will make a simple enclosure and show you a time lapse of 3D printing it. If you do not have a 3D printer, you can use any other nice looking box which can hold the liquid. Coming up! Welcome to my YouTube channel Green Eyed Explorer, where I explore further and beyond about tweaks, hacks, electronics and house repairs. Intro. Nowadays, air aromatizers are very popular. In my country, sellers are aware of it. So the price started 40 euros and can reach up to 150 euros. For a simple piezo element, which oscillates at certain frequency, that is too expensive. As a handyman, I decided to make my own. At first, I wanted to build an oscillator from scratch, but shortly afterwards, I decided to buy the corresponding element and power supply as they cost only around 7 euros. This is way cheaper than building one. You can find the link to a cheap but good supplier in the description below or on my homepage. The one I have has a dry run protection. This means when the liquid evaporates, the machine stops. As always, if you find this tutorial educational, please hit like button below, share this video with your friends, comment below if you want more tutorials and have suggestions, and don't forget to subscribe to my channel and click the notification bell next to it. You can even support my work via Patreon or buy me a coffee, as I like coffee. Well, let's start. How does it work? The aromatizers work by oscillating the piezo element at certain frequency. Piezo element is a crystal between two conducting plates which deform under the voltage, so it makes the air or the water above it vibrate. You may know them from sound playing greeting cards. It vibrates the liquid so that small micro droplets are formed. They are small enough to stay in the air in the form of mist. If you want to know more about piezo elements, comment below. The package. Let's see what I've received in the package. I'll do the unpacking. It comes well packed. Declaration says it runs at 24 volts up to 0.6 amps, which means 14.4 watts. Let's open it. As you can see, there is a round actuator with several color LEDs. I'll loosen the cables. The cable length seems to be long enough. Actuator diameter is a bit less than 5 cm or 2 inches. The power adapter is declared to supply 24 volts 1 amp. All that said, let's test it. It works. It makes magic mist and blows the water in the air. We will need a high enclosure. Design, assembly, testing. I designed the enclosure in FreeCAD. We only need to measure a piezo element diameter. I will show you a glimpse of my design. You can find it on Thingiverse.com. The link is in the description below. On the time lapse, you can see the first version. There is an elevated edge above the overhangs in the lower cup for the top part. When finished, the top cup was sunken in and the mist coming out was sparse. After testing, I figured out the bottom cup edge should be at the same level as the overhangs. This yielded to the final version. Here you can see it. This way, there is no water spraying and the mist coming out is thick. Another path I could have taken is to include a small fan, but this would have taken more parts and work. I am keen on making things easier. The final design has 3D printed bottom part which holds the glass above. Glass is transparent and it makes a prettier final product. So let's put parts together. Put an element and pull the cable through the hole and plug the rubber. You can use some silicone if you find it leaking. Now pour in some water and cover the device with glass. Now let's see how it works. Thank you for watching and see you next time.